As it is very common to see students getting confused when choosing among the two most prominent colleges in the field of food technology, that is ICT and NIFTIM, for pursuing their studies. I myself having an experience of studying in both the colleges, this has helped me to understand the various aspects of both the colleges. In this video, we shall discuss the different aspects of both the colleges, which will help you to make a more informed decision. Welcome to FoodM. So in this video, we are going to discuss 11 different criteria and give them points, wherein anything good about either of the college will get 1 point. So in the end, the total of the points will reveal the best college. So the first criteria is history of college. Talking about ICT Mumbai, the Food Engineering and Technology Department of ICT Mumbai was established back in 1943, completing its 76 years in 2019. NIFTIM, on the other hand, is the brainchild of Ministry of Food Processing Industry, MFPI, Government of India, established 8 years back in 2012. So, the older the wiser, ICT gets a point here. Coming to the next criteria, the location of the college, ICT is located in Matunga area of central Mumbai, while NIFTIM is located in the industrial estate region of Kundli on Delhi-Haryana border. So being located at India's one of the most popular metropolitan city, ICT get yet another point. The next criteria is infrastructure. Being equipped with all kinds of basic and sophisticated instruments, the labs of both the colleges are self-sufficient. However, NIFTIM spreads over an area of 100 acres, while ICT 16 acres. From having separate pilot plant come incubation centers, 4 different excellence centers, including International Grain, Food Safety, Bakery, and Food Convergent Innovation Center, a 5-story NIFTIM Knowledge Center, individual hostel rooms, and high-tech classrooms, NIFTIM scores a plus point for this very criteria. Coming to the next criteria, faculty. Both the institute have highly qualified and brilliant faculties in their specialized areas, together with international collaboration in teaching and research. So, for this very criteria, both the colleges get 1 point each. Moving to the next criteria, research. So going by facts, ICT's achievements in last 5 years include major grant acceptance like UGC, TechWeb, MFPI, ICR, DBT, DST and AICT, together with a total amount of approximately Rs. 7 crore. The major research publication in last 5 years include 192 international publications and 11 patents. NIFTIM, on the other hand, is still growing in the area of research and is having a Rs. 31 lakh project fund by ICMR, together with 22 internally funded projects in line. So for its experience, ICT gains yet another point for this very criteria. Moving to the next criteria, it is entrepreneurship. Unlike research, NIFTIM holds an upper hand when talking about entrepreneurship because NIFTIM encourages their students to build themselves as potential entrepreneurs. NIFTIM also provides an innovation fund scheme for their students and provide all kind of support and platform for realization of their innovative research idea and finding solutions to the problems faced at present by the food processing sector in India. So for this criteria, NIFTIM gets a positive point. The next criteria is courses offered and department. In ICT, there is only one department of food, namely Food Engineering and Technology Department. It offers BTech in Food Engineering and Technology, MTech in Food Biotechnology and Food Engineering and Technology, and PhD for both science as well as technology background. Talking about NIFTIM, it has 5 different departments, namely Agricultural and Environmental Sciences, Basic and Applied Sciences, Food Engineering, Food Science and Technology, and Food Business Management and Entrepreneurship Development. The courses offered by NIFTIM include BTech in Food Science and Technology, MTech in 5 different specialization, that is FTM, FSQM, FSCM, FPEM and FPOM, then MBA in Food and Agribusiness Management, and PhD in each of the above listed department. So for offering a variety of food subjects together with entrepreneurship and management, NIFTM scores a point here. Moving to the next criteria, internship and placement. Both the institute have separate students training and placement committee, wherein this committee on the behalf of institute extend training and placement opportunities to the students. However, placement trend changes with respect to year in terms of positions and placement and packages provided to the students by the company. So for this very criteria, both the colleges gain 1 point each. Moving to the next criteria, life on campus. Talking about life on campus, both the institutes have their students' cultural and technical associations for conducting workshops, annual fairs, technical sessions, and guest lectures. However, keeping in mind the location factor of ICT Mumbai for its easy access to all the things required by students, ICT Mumbai gets a point here. Moving to the next criteria, it is fees and scholarship. In comparison, the fees of ICT is slightly higher than NIFTM. The fees of BTech course in ICT is approximately 85,000, while for NIFTM it is 72,000 approximately. For MTech, the fees in ICT is 70,000 approximately, and the fees of MTech course in NIFTM is approximately 63,000. The fees of PhD in ICT is 65,000 approximately, and it is 78,000 approximately for NIFTM. Apart from it, in both the colleges, GATE qualified students get a scholarship of 12,400 for the MTech course. And apart from it, both the colleges also provide the economically deprived students assistance in tuition fee, mess fees, and hostel fee, along with the traveling allowance via different merit cum scholarship. So for this very criteria, both the colleges get equal point. Moving to the last criteria of discussion, foreign exchange program. So unlike ICT, in NIFTM, every year, three meritorious BTech students and five meritorious MTech students from each branch are provided an opportunity to go to foreign universities under the student exchange program for their academic learning. Apart from it, another very unique program initiated by NIFTM is VAP, or Village Adoption Program, wherein it aims to enlighten the students regarding the grassroots problems of the villagers and the farmers and understand their supply chain and come up with the best possible solution to their problems using their knowledge in food technology. So for these distinct initiatives by NIFTM gets it another point. Thus, we can see from the final score that both ICT and NIFTM are equally great colleges in the field of food technology in India, both having their own unique qualities. We cannot say that one college is better than other. Both institutes have their pros and cons, and it is up to you to decide which college you want to join in based on the parameter you are giving more importance to. Nonetheless, both the colleges are great where you can experience great education, and we hope this video helped you to understand better about ICT and NIFTM and also help you in deciding the college you want to join in. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and if you have any doubt regarding this video, please comment below.